Do we ever stop learning? You weren't born just knowing how to ride a bike or write your name. This was something that you had to learn to do as a child. Imagine there are things your parents or older brothers and sisters could do that you couldn't, like maybe reading a chapter book or driving a car. There are new things to you, but imagine you didn't think they were impossible tasks and are things you probably learned to do with a little bit of practice and now feel quite easy. How does this happen? How can we keep learning new things? We used to think our brains would fill up once we grew up, and that adults couldn't continue to learn the way that children can. Science and research have proven otherwise. It turns out that our brains never really get full because they're always changing. When we were young, we had the advantage of having billions of little workers inside our brains that were really excited to learn new things. We also have this environment where there are a lot of new things that our brains have never experienced before. So imagine a baby looking at Christmas lights for the first time, or going down a slide or a swing, or seeing a TV or hearing music. Everything is a new experience. This environment is like fertilizer for the soil. It helps the billions of little workers in our brains talk to each other and grow really fast because everything we experience at this critical time is new and our workers consider it very important. With so many little workers in our brain, they can work together in teams to figure things out faster, and over time they get stronger and better at the jobs we ask them to do. And the more we ask them to do, the better they continue to get. As workers get stronger and faster, we need few of them to do the job. A task that once felt hard is now easy. It's likely that the brain uses less power than it used to. And you may have noticed that as we get older, new things feel harder to learn, like using a computer or a smartphone, or learning a new language, especially when you see a 5-year-old learning how to play with an iPad after a day at randomly pressing keys. Have you ever experienced this or something similar? Why do things feel harder to learn as we get older? One way to think about it is that we have less to learn than a child. There are far fewer first-time experiences, and our little workers in our brain have gotten really used to the same things. As a result, our brain doesn't produce as much fertilizer to grow stronger or faster little workers, because they are doing just fine with the workers they have. It's kind of like autopilot. We don't have to think too hard to accomplish our day-to-day routines. You may have also experienced certain things you used to practice a lot as a teenager or young adult, and you haven't done for many years now, are really challenging. Maybe you're a really good pianist, but you haven't played in 20 years, and you can't quite move your fingers the way you used to. Why do you think that is? Do you think it could get better again? I'm sure you've heard the saying, if you don't use it, you lose it. And that is as close as it gets to the truth. If you stop using some brain workers by not practicing, the workers get bored and start to find other jobs to do, or some are recruited to other assembly lines. Once these workers find a new job to be part of, they have to be recruited again to do the old job by asking them with practice and consistency and under the right circumstances. It's like we have to give them a raise to produce the conditions they want to work in. Furthermore, if not given any other job to do, these little workers might just take a nap until they're needed. If they're never needed to do any new things and they just do the same things as they always do, they might take a really long nap to not waste any more brain power. In this case, it makes it really hard to wake them up again when we want to do something new. What happens to your brain after trauma? In some more extreme cases, we may lose some workers permanently to conditions like stroke or traumatic brain injury. Some of these workers might be really important for the assembly line to function to do a job, like feeding herself, for example. The good news is that with enough practice, we can find detours and recruit workers that find this new job, say moving a hand to feed yourself, more important, and they can be retrained. If we lose a lot of workers, we may not actually be able to do the same things we used to do, but we can definitely improve and continue to learn with the workers we have left. Why you can forget how to do things you've done before? Can you think of a time when something you wanted to learn was really easy or really hard? What do you think it made it easier or take longer to get the hang of? You may have grandparents or parents that have noticed and experienced some challenges in how they remember things or even find words in a conversation. Sometimes this is just a result of a lot of napping workers that haven't spoken to each other in many, many years and need to be stimulated in some way to be jolted back awake. This is true for how we move too, for example, our balance or even our fine motor skills. Just think if you haven't written an essay with a pen and paper for some time, your hand would likely cramp after a few minutes of writing. This process of our brain using little workers or neurons to learn new skills or unlearn skills is called neuroplasticity. It is a fancy way of saying our brains are always changing depending on what we ask them to do. You can think of the pathways that you take to learn something like a fresh snow-covered hill. If you sled down and make a path in the snow, it will be easier and faster to go down that same path again and again. The assembly line of workers is aware of the job and has recruited a team to do it well in this type of pathway. However, it is harder and slower to make a new path in the snow because it would require recruiting new workers, building new teams, and practicing together each time. Can you think of a bad habit you have learned over time and might want to change? Do you think this could be applied to the ways we think as well? Four things to consider when learning a new skill. We now know that there are some ways we can fertilize our billions of brain workers to wake them back up as adults. Some of these include, first, trying new things with focused attention. This means do not multitask because it doesn't give our workers clear instructions or the right environment for learning. You need to pay attention to what you're trying to learn. Two, aerobic exercise. This is exercise that gets your heart pumping blood to your muscles and your brain. This extra blood to your brain can help with fertilizer production and get your workers primed for their best learning. Third, being able to find a calm state in which to learn. We have probably all experienced the stress of a test coming up and find the more nervous and scared we are, the more we read the same line over and over without understanding anything. When we are in this anxious state, our little workers think we are under threat and are more focused on protecting us rather than learning how to figure out the task at hand. And fourth, we generally think of learning new things as a good thing, but sometimes we can learn bad habits along the way that become really tough to unlearn. Just think about the sled wanting to keep going down that same path over and over because it's easier and faster. This can kind of be related to relearning a golf swing. When you get in a bad habit in a golf swing, trying to change the way you swing can be really challenging.